So we are in July and we do not gratefully have a lot of cosmic shifts going. So for this week that is coming, I just want to inform you about the full moon eclipse in Capricorn at 13 degrees. This full moon eclipse, if you're on the Pacific coast, happens at 9:44 p.m. If you're on the East coast, it happens at 12:44 a.m. on July 5th. In the United States, this full moon eclipse happens on the United States solar return, its birthday. I feel that we are in a very exciting time in U.S. history. I do hope that the tides are changing for the better. We are still in a Mercury retrograde, but let's talk about the astrology of this full moon eclipse. If you'd like to see a screenshot of the chart, you can always head over to my show notes in The Savvy Luminary. One of the most striking things about this full moon eclipse is that it is forming a T-square to Chiron, meaning the push and pull between our emotional needs, the moon, and our life force needs, the sun, are being triggered by Chiron, the wounded healer. This will be an amazing day for a release ceremony. This full moon eclipse in Capricorn is about releasing, about letting go, about forgiving, as well as for thanking and celebrating, right? Oftentimes, you know, we all have past hurts, and these past hurts, you know, sometimes if they're super, super uncomfortable, we try to avoid them and not talk about them and numb ourselves from them. But if there is a way for you to recognize these past hurts as gifts of things that have molded you into the person that you are today, if you can forgive yourself or the person that hurt you or the experiences that you had, you know, it takes their power away. If you can, you know, look at your deepest pains and see them as gifts so that you can let them go, you thank them, right? Like Marie Kondo, I think, what does she say when she does a let go? She's like, tell them thank you and let them go. Thank you for your service. So looking at your deepest pains, they will be triggering some of your emotional self on the full moon. It is going to be a day where emotions are running high, because not only is it squaring with Chiron, but Chiron is right next to Mars. So I can imagine some, you know, tempers flaring a little bit. I don't know if there's going to be fireworks, but you can almost imagine the fireworks as the flaring of your emotions. On the day of the eclipse, we still have Jupiter and Pluto in close conjunction. They're not exact, but they're still both at 23 degrees Capricorn, about 10 degrees away from the moon. So we're feeling a lot of Capricorn energy right now. Capricorn energy is about, at its highest level, about social responsibility. It's about us achieving and getting results and achieving our goals and building structures and systems so that we can be more efficient and in our social climate responsible. So I'm curious to know for you, all of these themes that come up with past hurts, with anger, with security, emotional security, as well as vital physical security. What comes up for you? What needs to be let go and released so that you can move on to do the bigger and better things? If you're interested in healing your money stories and healing the way that you think about your superpowers and your brand and the way that you show up in your brand, consider joining my flagship program, Luminary Rising, for 1 month, the month of July. In July, we're going to be focusing on all things moon. In the last episode about how our moon sign affects our brand, I gave you 5 different keys as to how the moon affects your business. We're going to be diving into each of those keys in our business. And if you're interested in joining us, I'm looking for 5 to 10 more people to join us for this deep dive in July in Luminary Rising. during the month of July in the membership, we're going to have three special live ceremonies. We're going to be having a moon sign reading where I will be doing group readings for each person. And we're going to be having a new moon intention. And then we're going to be having a Q&A. Those are going to be the live sessions. Then we also have all of these trainings and an accountability group that's going to help you really dissect your moon sign, understand what motivates you, work through all of the fears that hold you back, and get to your why so you can really show up more confidently and aligned in your business. If you're interested in joining, head over to thesavvyluminary.com/rising and join us for the month of July. Normally, I only invite people for a quarterly or annual investment, but because I feel that the moon sign is so important, you can join for just the month of July for only $299 US. If you're interested, head over to thesavvyluminary.com/rising. Well, that's all I have for you this week. Welcome to July, and we can take a little bit of breath to do some integrative work. Until next week. Mahalo for listening to this brand new podcast. If you enjoyed learning about astrology for entrepreneurs, help me spread the word by sharing this podcast with your business besties. And hop over to The Savvy Luminary for links to episode notes and our free Facebook community where you can send me questions about astrology or branding, as well as connect with other like-minded businesses.